And sometime, make the time to drive out west into County Clare along the flaggy shore in September or October, when the wind and the light are working off each other so that the ocean on one side is wild with foam and glitter, and inland among stones, the surface of a slate-gray lake is lit with the earth lightning of a flock of swans, their feathers ruffed and ruffling white on white, their fully grown headstrong-looking heads tucked or cresting or busy underwater. Useless to think you'll park and capture it more thoroughly. You are neither here nor there, a hurry through which known and strange things pass, as big soft buffetings come at the car sideways and catch the heart off guard and blow it open.
After some time, one starts to feel that one doesn't belong to the rest of the world because you live apart from it on your own. I was really moved. I had never understood how much people cared. I knew they cared, but not to such an extent.
The song that I'll be singing coming in is a song that we sing to thank the day, to thank moment, particular moment in our lives. And I've been through communist dictatorship where freedom of speech have been taken away from me, or the freedom to write the song and the music that I want have been taken away from me, and I have to fled my country. And living in exile is something that I don't take lightly, because if you have never done that, you don't know how hard it is when you stay 6 years without being able to speak to your mom and dad. So thanks, for me, is very important in my life.
And so it is. The colder water, the blower's daughter, the pupil in denial. I can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off of you. I can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off of you. Just can't take my eyes.
What's going on, Dublin? How y'all feeling out there this evening? It's a beautiful thing, this thing called freedom of speech here. Freedom to say what you want.
I can't take back the words I made.
a bunch of bullshit. Just a poor excuse for you to use up all your bullets. How much money does it take to really make a full clip? 9/11, Building 7, did they really pull it? Huh? And a bunch of other cover-ups. Your child's future was the first to go with budget cuts. If you think that hurts, then wait, here comes the uppercut. School was garbage in the first place, that's on the up and up. Keep you at the bottom, but teach you with the upper crush. You get it, then they move it, so you never keeping up enough. If you turn on TV, all you see's a bunch of what the fucks. Do this, they need so-and-so, never read about such and such. That ain't Jersey Shore, homie, that's the news. And these the same people supposed to be telling us the truth. Limbo is a racist, Limbeck is a racist. Gaza Strip was getting bomb, Obama didn't say shit. That's why I ain't voting for him, next one either. I'm a part of the brother, my problem is I'm peaceful. And I believe in the people.
You asked me to enter, then you made me crawl. And I can't be holding on to what you've got. And all you got is hurt. One love, one blood, one life. You get to do what you should.
Throughout these years, Amnesty International have helped us to keep our small wick of self-respect alight. You have helped us to keep the light. And we hope that you will be with us in the years to come, that you will be able to join us in our dreams and not take either your eyes or your mind off us, and that you will help us to be the country where hope and history merges. Thank you.
I don't think I can ever remember another political leader, other than maybe a Gandhi or Martin Luther King, mentioning kindness. You know, people talk about justice, people talk about human rights, people talk about freedom, but they don't talk about something as basic and as fundamental as the importance of human kindness.